It's been over 35 years since the original Chernobyl disaster. Even now, the city of Pripyat is off-limits in most cases. The area surrounding it is still deserted, and countries like Ukraine and Belarus are still facing the economic and environmental damage caused by it. According to some observers, Chernobyl might just be close to another disaster that's just waiting to happen. Let's dive into that and some other nuclear disasters. Chernobyl disaster. It was a pretty average day for Pripyat residents on April 25, 1986, back when Ukraine and nearby Belarus were still part of the Soviet Union. Shortly after the day had ended and midnight had passed, workers at the nearby Chernobyl nuclear power were busy as usual, conducting their daily safety checks. One of these tests included decreasing and increasing the reactor power of a steam turbine of an RBMK-type nuclear reactor to see if everything was working smoothly. However, while they were doing that test, the RBMK-type nuclear reactor ended up losing almost all of its power, and the scientists there were unable to bring it back to safe levels. Instead of reporting it to some higher authority, they pretty much ignored it and continued doing other tests. Since that specific reactor played an important role in the plant overall, the operators decided to shut down the nuclear reactor altogether, something that had very little precedence. What they didn't expect was just how unstable the plant had become due to that one incident, and how disastrous shutting down the whole reactor would be for the plant. Everything started to shut down on its own eventually, leading to an uncontrolled nuclear chain reaction, a reaction that produces several million times the energy per reaction than any other chemical reaction. Suddenly, the world saw some of the biggest accidental explosions ever, the biggest of which was a steam explosion caused by the vaporization of superheated cooling water. Other explosions followed suit, including other potential steam explosions, small nuclear explosions, and even hydrogen deflagration. All of these explosions led to a reactor core meltdown, which released an unfathomable amount of radioactive contamination that went airborne all over the region, making it deadly to go outside or even stay inside your house. The only place where you'd be safe would be in an airtight container. Around 70,000 people in total had to be evacuated because of the incident. The death toll isn't clear since they kept occurring for years after the incident, but most estimates place the death toll at around 100 for the day of the incident itself, and potentially 16,000 for the years to come. It's considered the deadliest nuclear explosion since the Allied attack on the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945. Chernobyl might be in trouble 35 years later. According to some news reports in 2021, nuclear reactors in the now-defunct Chernobyl nuclear power plant continue to have small bursts of unstable energy. These reactions are small, but the researchers that work there have noticed a steady spike in the energy that is being released from the power plant, specifically some reactors located in the basement of the plant in a room called 3052. The room is far too dangerous to access or even open. It's almost completely barricaded by debris and a radioactive mush of multiple deadly chemicals. The fact that the neutron levels are rising in this room could have some potentially deadly consequences for the region once again. It means that the radioactive mush we talked about is hardening and almost turning into a sort of nuclear lava. As it further hardens, it's only going to create more and more unstable, uncontrolled energy, and who knows how much longer this process is going to continue if there isn't any immediate human intervention in the process. Researchers at the University of Sheffield warned that the process is somewhat like embers in a barbecue pit, and that untimely action would almost guarantee another explosion. To make matters worse, this process has been going on for over 4 years, and it was only now that it actually started to worry scientists, who seemed pretty unbothered by it before. The fact that even experts are worried about this should speak volumes about what the potential for damage can be in the case if this continues. However, even if the room does end up exploding, this time the experts are prepared for it. The explosion is unlikely to be anywhere near as big as the original ones, and if it actually is on the brink of happening, it will almost certainly be contained. Nuclear energy has become a lot more secure, partly thanks to the Chernobyl explosion itself, which led to a lot stricter rules being set by the IAEA, which all nuclear plants around the world have to adhere to in order to avoid devastating sanctions. At the same time, no one has figured out how to actually get to the room yet. It's still almost completely inaccessible, at least when you factor in the safety of the researchers. It's in everyone's best interests that the researchers figure out how to do that before things get out of hand. While another explosion won't be as deadly as the original, since most people living in the area have already been evacuated, it could delay the recovery process for the Chernobyl impact zone by some decades, if not make it unlivable forever. The region is expected to become livable again by 2060, and even now, some families that had missed the city they lived in have returned, albeit with a lot more restrictions on their lives than before. An interesting scenario that may play out here is the use of robots. Since technology has progressed so much since the initial Chernobyl explosion, we don't even need to risk human lives in order to avoid a disaster. Some scientists are suggesting that instead of sending humans to inspect the room that contains all these radioactive materials, we send robots instead. While these robots aren't there yet, they can easily be created and controlled with the level of technology we have available to us right now. Fukushima. Chernobyl may have been the worst nuclear accident in history, but it certainly wasn't the only nuclear explosion to cause a literal storm. During the horrific 2011 Japanese earthquake and tsunami, which saw the deaths of up to 20,000 people, the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant ended up having an explosion that was dangerously similar to the one that happened in Chernobyl. In fact, it's the only nuclear accident to have received a Level 7 classification on the International Nuclear Event Scale after Chernobyl. The entire city of Okuma had to be evacuated as a result, despite the Japanese government already being burdened with the aftermath of the earthquake and tsunami itself. In total, around 154,000 people were evacuated by the government. The initial incident itself took the life of only one person. However, just as with Chernobyl, deaths continue to happen due to the incident. The Fukushima incident isn't as widely known, partially due to the fact that it occurred at the same time as a massive earthquake and tsunami, and partially due to the fact that very little human miscalculation was initially thought to be the cause of the incident. But further research showed that that may not have been the case after all. The Japanese government set up an independent investigation of the whole incident the following year. Its goal was to figure out whether there may have been some protocols that were ignored that could potentially prevent this disaster from happening. The investigation concluded that there was very little and, according to some sources, almost no oversight over the Fukushima power plant at all. They also said that there was a conflict of interest by the Japanese regulatory authority, which was meant to regulate nuclear energy, but ended up promoting nuclear energy regardless of the risk it may have. Eventually, the operator of the plant, TEPCO, also admitted that it failed to take measures to avoid the accident. The investigation itself concluded that the incident could have been avoided had the right measures been taken. Is nuclear power safe? Since the incidents of Chernobyl and Fukushima have almost been ingrained into everyone's subconscious at this point, there have been lots of questions raised over the safety of nuclear power in general. Many people are still wary of nuclear power plants being built close to where they live, and there are certainly many reasons to be worried about that. But do those two incidents really mean that nuclear power is inherently unsafe? Well, no. With both Chernobyl and Fukushima, not enough measures were taken to prevent such an incident. In reality, nuclear energy is completely safe, but only if all the protocols are strictly followed. Nuclear energy is one of the cleanest alternatives to conventional power sources like oil and gas. Countries like France are already heavily reliant on nuclear energy and are now even exporting nuclear energy to neighbouring countries. As technology progresses, nuclear energy is only bound to become safer. Incidents like Chernobyl and Fukushima will, over time, become almost impossible. If that happens, we might finally see nuclear energy as a viable alternative, instead of just a scary boogeyman in the energy industry. That's a wrap for the Chernobyl disaster. Do you think that Chernobyl is on the brink of another disaster? Let us know in the comments below. As always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to SEMA's Top 10 for more videos like this. See you in the next one.